So you've just been handed a PDF file of some slides that are completely unbranded, and it's your job now to convert them into a beautiful set of PowerPoint slides which are totally on brand. Oh, and by the way, you need to do that by the end of the day. As a former PA, that would have been my worst nightmare, but not anymore, because I'm going to show you how to easily convert a PDF file to a set of PowerPoint slides in under 2 minutes using just one free tool. Not only that, I'm going to show you how to add your own fonts and colours so that the slides match your own brand's visual style before downloading them to PowerPoint. Welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nikki Pasquier. I'm a Canva expert and I help small businesses and startups successfully market their brands online using the exact same strategies that I use. So if this is something that interests you, you might want to consider subscribing to my channel and then just click on that little bell notification so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Okay, I'm dying to get started, so if you wouldn't mind, follow me over to my Canva desktop. So first things first, I'm going to start off with step number one. I'm going to show you how to upload your PDF file to Canva. So starting off on your Canva homepage, you're going to go to the top right hand corner of your screen and click on this purple button, Create a Design. And that will bring up a quick menu of suggested templates. But we're going to ignore that because we're going to go right down to the bottom and then click on Import File. Click on it and now find the PDF file from your laptop or PC. And this is mine, my PDF. So I'm going to select it, click Open, and I'm working on a Mac, by the way, so your screen might look slightly different. Whilst your PDF file is importing to Canva, you'll be taken to your projects, which is in the left-hand side column right here. And your PDF will be uploaded to the Designs tab. Now, don't worry, because your projects will look very different from mine because I've created lots of folders, but I promise you, you will find your uploaded PDF right here. And this is mine, and that's already uploaded. So I'm going to click on it once to open it up into my Canva desktop. Fabulous. First things first, that looks really good. I'm just going to minimize this bar here so we've got a nice clean space. Get rid of that. So as you can see, this presentation has got some very different font to my own fonts. I've got Montserrat, I've got Times New Roman. Does anybody use that now? So I'm going to show you how to quickly rebrand these slides before downloading them to PowerPoint. And I'm going to start off by showing you how to rebrand your text. So starting off with the header style, click your cursor into the text box. I'm just going to resize that slightly, give myself plenty of room. And now I'm going to change this text for my own brand font. And this is the first of my Nikki Ninja tips. What you're going to do with the text box still selected, go up to the top left-hand corner of your Canva toolbar and click on the font pull-down menu. At this point, I do really recommend that you have a brand kit set up properly. You will need Canva Pro for this, but if you keep watching, I'll give you a link to a free 45-day upgrade to help you do that. So I'm going to scroll down until I find my own brand kit. And for the purpose of this tutorial, I've created a mock-up brand kit called Mad Frog Print on Demand. And underneath, I can see that I have my two fonts already set up. So I have this one as my header and this one as my subheader. So I'm now going to click on the header style to change the header in my presentation. And my heading now is completely on brand. So that's one header changed. But obviously, if you have 25 slides to edit, you don't want to go through this process for every single slide. So here's what you might want to do. Go right down to the bottom of this left-hand side column and you'll see a purple button that says Change All. And it's inviting me to change all instances of Montserrat to my brand header font. Be really careful though before you do click on Change All, because it really will change all instances of one font for another throughout your entire document. Once you are sure, just click on Change All. And I can now see, if I click on the little thumbnail images of each slide, that each header throughout my document has been changed. You might need to make some little adjustments because it's not a perfect solution, but it really doesn't take very long. Fantastic. And now I'm going to do exactly the same with my subheading. I'm going to select the text box, go up to the text pull down menu, find my brand fonts, click on my subheading font style, and then I'm going to go right down to the bottom and I want to change all instances of this Times New Roman to my brand font. If I just check on the other slides in my document, I can see that all subheadings have been changed to the correct font style. Just going to adjust them slightly. Fabulous. By the way, if you're enjoying this tutorial so far, please do give it a thumbs up because it will help YouTube recommend it to other people as well. Now, just as you can change all instances of one font for another in Canva, you can do exactly the same with colors. So let me just click on this slide here to open it up. And I really don't like this gray color, so I'm going to change it for one of my own brand colors. So let me just click on this gray photo frame to select it. I'm going to go to the top left-hand corner of my Canva toolbar and click on the color tab. And that brings up the color menu. And just as I had with text, I have my own brand colors right here. So I think I'm going to swap the gray color with my brand yellow. So I'm going to click on the yellow thumbnail. And again, if I go right down to the bottom of the color column, I've got this change all button, which is inviting me to change all instances of this rather dull gray with my brand yellow. And again, be very careful before you click on this button because it really will swap all instances of one color for another. And that includes text as well. I'm quite happy with that, so I'm going to go ahead and click on Change All. And I can see that all instances of grey throughout my document have now been changed. Now there's just one last thing I need to do before I download my slides to PowerPoint. And if I click on the final slide, I want to copy and paste this lovely gradient background to the first slide as well. So all I need to do is make sure I've selected the gradient background with my cursor, and I'm going to use my Mac shortcut key to copy it, click on the first thumbnail, and then paste it directly into my slide. It's pasted over the top of all my other elements, so all I need to do to change that is go to the top right hand corner of my Canva toolbar and click on Position, and then select to the back. And that's all done. So the final step now is to download my Canva slides to PowerPoint. All I need to do is go to the share button in the top right hand corner of my Canva toolbar and click on it. And this layout has recently changed. So what I need to do now is go to the bottom of this menu and click on the More tab and scroll down until I find the Save section. And here I can see the Microsoft PowerPoint little thumbnail, and I'm going to click on it. Click on this little downward arrow to select the pages you want to download. I'm going to select them all. Click on Done, and then Download. And Canva will magically transport your Canva slides over to PowerPoint. And here is my beautiful PowerPoint slide deck. Now, previously, you would have had to have used my Nikki Ninja tip to export to PowerPoint. But as you can see, all my fonts and graphics have been exported absolutely perfectly. So that's one less step you need to take. For the final step, type this URL into your browsers to get a free exclusive 45-day upgrade to Canva Pro. I will also leave the link underneath this video. If you'd like to find out how to convert a PDF file to Word, I will leave a link for you right here. And I'll also leave a link to my entire playlist of Canva presentation tips and tricks right here. Thank you so much for watching and for all your support. As always, I will see you next time.